Hi, this is Jennifer Filla, and this is a Chat Bites member tip. It's my way of sharing tips and ideas from the courses that I'm developing for the Prospect Research Institute. And today I want to talk about approach to prospecting. This is a course that I've run two times before in the old platform, and we're uploading it to the new platform. So it should be available by the end of July this year, 2019. And one of the things I had happen, the two times I ran it before, there was some pushback from students about the communication piece. So this time, as I'm going through it, I'm looking that over again, like, how can I improve that? And then I sat down to watch television with my husband. Bear with me here, this is relevant. We sat down to watch a murder mystery, Midsummer Murders, actually. And you're probably not surprised. I'm a researcher. I love mysteries. I solve prospecting mysteries every day. So, of course, I'm paying attention to the detective. And I noticed some behavior that's consistent. And it's the detective's name is Barnaby. And Barnaby, when he's questioning suspects, you know, there's tension, right? They're suspects. It's a crime. It's a murder. So there's all this tension. He's asking questions, maybe not getting the answers he wants, but, you know, things are forming in his head. You can, like, see the wheels turning up there. And then he and his sergeant turn and they walk to the door. And then almost always, I swear, he turns around and he says, "Oh," with a confused look on his face. "I have one more question for you." And he asks this question. It shifts the entire dynamics between himself and that suspect. The suspect, the guard is down. He thought he was done. And then all of a sudden, Barnaby turns around and asks him another question. And it usually, like, pulls some things together. And the suspect, not only is the guard down, but then is like, whoa. So that kind of tactic is what I was trying to convey as a good communication tactic with a requester. So when you're prospecting and you have a little tension, even when you don't have tension, clarifying requests with a little confusion, it's helpful. But if you have some tension where you have, like, a high demanding development officer, maybe someone who's sort of testing you or isn't fully on board with how research works, and you act a little confused and want clarification on something they're asking about. And I'll give you an example. So when we're prospecting for new, communication is so critical. So when the requester says to me, "I really want this person to be qualified." Well, I don't know what that means. It could mean one thing to me and something completely different to the requester. And if I don't clarify that, I risk delivering something that will make them very unhappy. And if I already have a little bit of tension in the relationship, we haven't built rapport, that's even worse. So being a little confused is not, "I don't know how to do my job." It's, "I want to do my job the best, and I know what that is, but I have to make sure that we agree." So I'm a little confused about that qualification piece. So what do you mean by qualification? Or do you mean this by qualification, if you want to, like, sound like you know what you're doing? But a little confusion kind of shifts the dynamic there. People tend to want to help someone who's confused, and that's helpful because I need to know what you're really requesting. So that's what that's all about. I'm suggesting that, contrary to making you look like you don't know what you're doing, acting a little bit confused and getting clarification on things means that you do. You may not feel that way, and you may have something that you do that's completely different and you think better. I want to know about it. So if you don't agree, or if you have another tactic that you want to share, I'd love it if you would do that. You can get me all kinds of ways. I'm on LinkedIn. You can get my email pretty easily, jen@prospectresearchinstitute.org. And if you're one of our members, one of our many members, you can put a message on Slack. We have a shareables channel. And Deborah Drucker, shout out, I'm totally thinking about you because I'm looking at the book on my bookshelf called Influence Without Authority, which you recommended in that class, Approach to Prospecting. So happy to have you in that class. So thrilled that you are still a member, and it's a great book. So totally recommend reading that as well. Thank you for joining me today for this quick member tip, and I look forward to learning more with you. Can't wait to hear what you have to say about being a little confused.